this session, we will discuss burners used in atomic spectroscopy. Flame require fuel and oxidant in order to exist. Types of burners. Maker or fissure burner is used in the laboratory. It uses natural gas as fuel and air as oxidant. Temperature is 1800 degrees centigrade. It produces low temperature and low excitation energies. It is used for alkali metals and it is used for qualitative purpose. In flame test, salt is placed over the platinum wire and it is introduced into the flame. Burners used for atomic spectroscopic techniques are total consumption burner and premix burner or laminar flow burner. This is a laminar flow. In laminar flow, gas flow in which the lines of flow are approximately parallel and changes smoothly with respect to time and space. This is non-turbulent. This diagram shows total consumption burner. It is used in flame photometry. This diagram is of premix or laminar flow burner and it is used in atomic absorption spectrophotometry. It can also be used in flame photometry. Total consumption burner, fuel, oxidant and the sample all meet for the first time at the base of the flame. Fuel and oxidant are forced under pressure into the flame where sample is drawn by a process called aspiration through a small diameter plastic tube. What is aspiration? The rush of fuel and oxidant through the burner head creates a vacuum in the sample line and draws the sample from the sample container into the flame. Flame in total consumption burner is noisy and turbulent. Sometimes smaller drop, sometimes bigger drop comes in the flame. Total consumption burner is used in flame photometry. It is not useful for atomic absorption as resulting flame is turbulent. Total consumption burner has turbulent flame, which is non-homogeneous. For atomic absorption, the flame must be homogeneous, as non-homogeneous flame would result in change of its absorption properties from one moment to the next. That will negate the Beer's law applicability to atomic absorption. Emission in flame photometry, however, is not affected by the turbulence of flame as excited atoms instantly return to the ground state. Flame temperature can be adjusted by controlling fuel to oxidant ratio. Second type of burner is premix or laminar flow burner. This is the schematic diagram of premix or laminar flow burner. It is used in flame atomic absorption spectrophotometry. Flame is homogeneous. Gases move in a laminar flow, that is non-turbulent fashion. For absorption measurement, flame must be homogeneous and non-turbulent. sample is drawn from the sample container by the process of aspiration. It is nebulized, that is, it is split into fine mist. It is mixed with fuel and oxidant with the use of baffles prior to introduction into the flame. This is nebulizer. Sample comes from this side and nebulizing gas is forced so that sample is converted into aerosol. Nebulizer gas can be compressed air, oxygen or nitric oxide. A small portion of the sample, about 5% of the sample, in the form of very small droplets, reaches the flame where efficient atomization takes place. Larger droplets are drained out. Flame is non-turbulent, noiseless, and stable. This is the burner head of premix burner. Burner head has 4-inch to 6-inch long slot for the flame. The premixed fuel, oxidant, and the sample emerge from the burner head and are ignited, creating the flame. A faster burning mixture would require a burner head with smaller slot in order to discourage drying of flame inside the burner, causing a minor explosion. We will discuss comparison of total consumption burner and premix burner. Advantages: representative sample reaches the flame. Amount of sample in the flame is large. There is no explosion hazard in case of total consumption burner. In case of premix burner, path length is long, that provides sensitivity of the instrument. Only small droplets reach the flame. Here, more amount of the sample goes to flame. 5% of sample reaches the flame, atomizes, and there is less chance of clogging. It is quiet operation. Disadvantages include, for total consumption burner, there is a short path length and hence there is lower sensitivity. Large droplets not entirely decomposed into the flame. Rate of sample introduction depends upon the viscosity of the solvent. In case of premix burner, rate of sample introduction is low. There is possibility of explosion in the mixing chamber. Selective evaporation of mixed solvents can lead to analytical errors. In summary, we have discussed burners for atomic spectroscopic techniques, namely total consumption burner and premix burner or laminar flow burner, and the comparison between these two burners. Thanks for watching this video.